originating from small areas, wooded or mountainous areas in Japan, Hakone Chloas, in my opinion, are one of the most beautiful and graceful grasses. They form these really soft mounds of long, slender foliage, and they catch the slightest breeze, so they always feel like they're moving and swaying. The foliage of the species is a lovely, bright mid-green, but there's lots of other variegated forms and even golden ones available as well. So I've just got a couple here. You can see quite bright and golden and variously streaked and striped. The lovely thing about a lot of the Hakone Chloas, they do die down in the winter, they are deciduous, but they'll often take on autumnal tints. So you do get at the tips of the leaves and then progressively further down the leaf blade become sort of reddish or almost burgundy throughout the autumn. Because they're so soft and mound forming, I think they make particularly good partners for really quite structured plants like Buxus. And they also go very well with things that have a distinctly upright. So they look beautiful under planting trees. They also look great when used to line the edges of a path because their foliage just really softens those hard lines, or you can use them to great effect as well to do the same thing at the front of the border. They prefer a moist but freely draining soil, relatively fertile, and they will tolerate full sun. But what I find is that the foliage may become a little scorched, and particularly so with the variegated forms. These prefer to be grown in partial shade. They also do very well in pots and containers, and don't overcrowd them on the patio. Let them sort of have their space, and they look really, really good. If the clumps do get big, they're not particularly fast growing, but if and when they do get too big, you can lift them and divide them in the spring.